Hello guys, welcome to my channel HY Tutorials. In this video, we will see how we can download the driver executable files using WebDriver Manager. So here I should not say download, I should say auto download, because we are not doing the downloading part. So the WebDriver Manager library is doing the downloading part for us. So it is auto download, not the download. So first, let me tell you what this driver executable file is. So if you're using Selenium WebDriver and you wanted to execute your scripts in one browser, you cannot directly interact to the browser from your scripts. So you need some intermediate thing. So that intermediate thing is driver executable file. So in a technical words, whatever the library you are using in your project, like let's say Selenium standalone server you are using, right? So that Selenium standalone server is a client-side library. And to execute all of the commands, you need one server also. So this driver executable file will act as a server for the browser. So whatever the commands you are sending from the Selenium standalone server will be understandable to the driver executable files. And from driver executable files, it will send a request to browser and it will get the response back from the browser and it will send that response to client, right? So that is how actually it will work. So in general terms, if you want to execute any script in any browser, you need the respective driver executable file to be available in your system. So that is in simple way, guys. So till now, in a traditional way, what we used to do, we used to download these driver executable files from the internet and add it to our project or keep them in a separate location and reference that location, right? So we need to perform two things actually. One is we need to download and place the library file in one location. Then we need to set the Java JVM properties like we used to set, right? System.setProperty, webdriver.chrome.driver or webdriver.gecko.driver like that. So that also we need to do. So with this WebDriver Manager, we can avoid all these things. So before moving to WebDriver Manager, first we'll see what are the problems. The two problems I told you what we can avoid. And one more thing, okay? If you are performing cross-browser testing for your product, imagine in how many browsers you need to execute your scripts. And we don't know when the browser will get the updates, okay? Chrome may release the next version tomorrow. Firefox may release day after tomorrow, right? So how many times your browser is getting updated, and every time your browser is updated, you need to download the respective driver executable file and again add it to your project, right? So this you need to do it for all the browsers. So now imagine the small tedious task became very big. And then next, if you want to set this automation project in another machine, some VM or somewhere, there also you need to perform all these things, right? So that is the reason I told you this task is a big tedious task. So let me show you manually how we do it, okay? So what we will do first, if I want to download any driver executable file. So here I am using Chrome browser as an example. So for Chrome browser, I need to download Chrome driver, right? So Chrome driver download, then search and go to this location. Then I need to download this Chrome driver. And before this, I need to verify the browser version installed in my machine. Then I need to choose the particular Chrome driver version. Then it will download me a zip file. I need to unzip that file and add the exe file to my project. So that is for one browser. Okay. So similarly, for all other browsers also, we need to follow the steps. So with this WebDriver Manager, how we can do? So what exactly this WebDriver Manager is? This WebDriver Manager is one library which can be added as a dependency. So if you are using a Maven project, in Maven project, what we will have? We will have dependencies, plugins, right? So this is a dependency. So when you add this dependency in your Maven project, it will download you the jar files, okay, for this WebDriver Manager. That jar file let you download, sorry, auto download the driver executable files. We can get this WebDriver Manager dependency in two ways. One, you can search in the Google for WebDriver Manager, okay? So just click on the first link that is from GitHub. So here you just have to come down and here you have the dependency, okay? So this is the official GitHub repository for WebDriver Manager, guys. If you have any other queries also, you can just come here and check. So they have given all the examples and everything they have given here. So from here you can copy or you can go to Maven repository. Just type MVN repository and go to this mvnrepository.com link. So here type WebDriver Manager. So just pick the first one, which is from GitHub. Then here you need to choose the version, which version of WebDriver Manager library you want. So let me go with latest. So then you will get the dependency details here. You can copy either this one or this one. So then go to your Eclipse or any other IDE, whatever you are using. So here I have one Maven project. So let me open the POM file. So here I will add the dependency. So let me save. So here it is downloading the libraries. So the download is completed. So now let me show you how we can use it. Okay, I'll create one class file. So I'll name this as auto download drivers. So I have added the main method here. So now let me show you how we can do that. So previously what we used to do, we used to set the system property first, then driver instance creation. Okay. So here you no need to set the system property. All you have to do is you need to tell which browser you want to use. Okay. So that setup will be taken care by WebDriver Manager. So how we do it? We have downloaded the WebDriver Manager, right? So the class name is also WebDriver Manager. So in this WebDriver Manager class, you need to choose the driver, which browser you are using. For example, if you are using Chrome, then you need to choose Chrome driver. Okay. Similarly, if you see here, this WebDriver Manager is providing support for almost all the browsers. Chrome driver, Chromium driver, Edge, Firefox, IE, Opera. Okay. So almost all of the browsers it is supporting. First, let me go with Chrome browser. So I need to go with Chrome driver. Then dot setup. So this single line will do the magic for us. So next one is the common. We need to create the instance for WebDriver. So I am creating for Chrome driver, right? So it is asking me to import the libraries. So next, let me navigate to Google homepage. So this is one simple line, guys. Very, very simple. So this line will do all the magic for us. So previously, in traditional way, first we should remember the keys. For every driver, we will have separate key, like webdriver.chrome.driver, webdriver.gecko.driver. So that key you need to remember, and you need to set that key, right? So all these things you can avoid, and you can simply use this in one line. So where actually these drivers will be downloaded? When I'm saying auto download, it is internally downloading in some location, right? If you are downloading manually, it will come to our downloads folder in C drive, right? But where this WebDriver Manager will download? So this WebDriver Manager is a dependency in our Maven project, right? So if we download anything from Maven, where it will go? It will go to Maven repository, the local Maven repository. So first let me open the local Maven repository here. So this is my local Maven repository. So here, do you see anything starts with WebDriver? No, right? That is because I haven't added the WebDriver Manager till now in my machine, or I have deleted that folder. So when you execute that script, it will download the Chrome driver here with root folder name as WebDriver. So internally, it will have Chrome driver and the version. So first let me execute, then we'll come back to this folder and see. So I'll right click on this Java application, run as. So you can see it launched the browser and it opened the Google homepage also. So now let me go back to my Maven repository. And now you can see here, it downloaded one WebDriver folder. So let me open this. So now I have downloaded the Chrome driver because I executed my script in Chrome browser. So let me open this also. And you can see here it downloaded the Win32 version, Win32 bit. And you can see my Chrome version is 80. So it downloaded the respective driver file for me. If your Chrome version is 81, it will download the 81 version driver file for you. So you no need to check the version also of your browser. This WebDriver Manager will check the installed browser version, and according to that, it will download the driver executable file. See how easy this is. So tomorrow, if there is a new version coming in, for example, let's say like my Chrome browser is updated to 81, I no need to change any command here. My command will be same. And without even knowing that my Chrome is updated, I will execute my scripts. And if that separate version driver is not available in the repository, what it will do? It will simply download from the internet and it will keep here. Then that version driver will be referenced internally and it will be used for the execution. So that is very easy, guys. So this is how we need to use the WebDriver manager. So this is a simple use case, and there are many use cases that you can go to this WebDriver manager GitHub page and you can check. So guys, if you are using Maven, this is the dependency. And if you are using Gradle, so this is the dependency. So then they have shown one simple example also for you. And they have shown here like for different browsers, how we use this line, single line. For Chrome, it is chromedriver.setup. For Firefox, it is firefoxdriver.setup. So like that they have shown here, okay? So next, for example, if you want to download a specific version, right? I told you like we can download the specific version. So you can use this. There is a method called version, okay? With that, you can download the specific version. If you come down here, they might have provided some examples for that also. So let me see. They haven't provided any examples, but okay. Let me just get some Chrome driver version. Then we'll try that. Okay, so I'll just take this Chrome driver version 79. Copy this, go to your project. So type for version. Then use setup. So just run this. So you can see it launched the browser and opened google.com also. And in the console also, you can see starting Chrome driver 79 version, right? Because I have used 79 version. So let me go back to repository and check. So here you can see the 79 version also downloaded. So this is how you can do the specific Chrome driver version testing also. So that is about WebDriver manager, guys. So I hope this video helps you. If you have any feedback or if you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.